Hello everyone. Today we are going to be demystifying organ donation after death. Organ donation is the gift of life, giving someone a second chance at life. Every year, hundreds of Canadians' lives are saved due to organ donation. Nearly 5,000 Canadians are on the wait list, waiting for life-saving organ transplants, and 250 Canadians die yearly waiting. Donors can donate organs, for example, the heart, lungs, kidneys, liver, pancreas, intestines, and the cornea. The most donated organ in Canada is the kidney, while the least is the intestines. But how does organ donation really work? To become an organ donor in Canada, you must be at least 16 years old, be able to provide your date of birth, and your health card number. It's actually quite rare to be eligible to donate your organs after death in Canada, with only 1 to 2% of people being eligible. This is because there are only two ways that a person can die in which they are able to donate their organs. The first way is if the patient has gone through neurological determination of death, aka brain death. This is a state where the patient no longer has any function in the brain and will not be able to regain consciousness or breathe without support. Organs that can be donated after this include the heart, lungs, kidneys, liver, pancreas, and the intestines. The second way is if a patient experiences circulatory death, which is what happens after a patient is involved with an accident that results in severe brain injuries and when the heart permanently stops beating. Typically, the liver, kidneys, lungs, and the pancreas can be donated in this case. If one of these two situations occur and the person is a registered organ donor, a process follows where the family is informed. Ultimately, the family is able to make the final decision on behalf of the patient, making sure to respect their wishes. If approved, the medical team will examine which organs are eligible for donation and blood tests will be done to ensure that the patient is still able to donate. Once this is complete, a recipient will be found through the National Transplant Waiting List. Typically, organs are donated to patients within the province, but can also be done across provinces. Once a recipient is found, the surgery to remove the organ begins immediately. This whole process of speaking to the family, doing various tests, and removing the organs can take anywhere between 24 to 36 hours. How are the organs stored and transported? Each organ must be free of blood before being removed from the donor. This is done with an ice-cold preservation solution that contains nutrients. Then these are individually put into sterile containers with wet ice and transported to the transplant center. The process of removal, storage, and transport must be done as quickly as possible because the heart and lungs have to be transplanted into the recipient's body within 4 hours of being removed from the donor. The liver must be transplanted between 12 to 18 hours. The kidney must be transplanted within 24 to 48 hours. And the pancreas and the intestines within 8 to 12 hours. Some myths that people associate with organ transplant, which creates fear preventing them from becoming organ donors, are that doctors will not try to save their life if they know they are a donor. Well, the truth is that the staff at the hospital will do everything possible to save your life. When you go for treatment, they are focused on saving your life, not someone else's. Secondly, that I'm too old to donate. There's actually no cutoff age for donating organs. However, the medical staff will evaluate your organs no matter how old you are, if you're an organ donor, and will qualify what is eligible and what is not eligible. And last, rich and famous people are on the top of the list. This simply is not true. There's actually no priority based on popularity or social status, but there are many factors that are used to determine who will be the recipient. So recipients will be matched based on factors including blood group. Having compatible blood type group is very important. For example, if a recipient was type A blood, they would only be able to receive an organ from a type A or type O blood type donor. They would not be able to get an organ from a donor who was type B or AB blood type. Additionally, if there was a type AB blood recipient, they would be able to receive transplants from any blood type donor. And type O recipients could only receive a transplant from a type O donor. If the transplant is done between incompatible blood types, your immune system's antibodies will actually attack these foreign antigens, which can cause life-threatening side effects. Next, height and weight are also looked upon as factors. The closer you are to the donor's height and weight, the higher up on the list you'll be. Next, size of the organ is also looked at. For example, if a child is a donor, children on the waiting list will be higher up than adults. And then medical emergency. They check how long the person can survive without the transplant, and the sickest people are higher up on the list. And then how long the person has been on the waiting list is also looked at, and the distance between the donor and possible recipient. The geographical distance is very important because the closer the donor is to the recipient, the higher on the list they'll actually be. Here is a real case study in Canada where organ donation saved multiple lives. Meet Logan Boulet, a young, courageous hockey player who passed in the tragic Humboldt Broncos bus crash in April of 2018 in Canada. He had registered to become an organ donor just weeks before this accident, inspired by his previous coach. The morning after the accident, his parents were told that he had irreversible brain damage, and they decided to donate his organs. He was able to save 6 lives with his organ donation and inspire thousands across Canada to become organ donors. Did you know that 90% of Canadians approve organ donation, yet only 32% of them are registered organ donors? One organ donor can save up to 8 lives. You can also make a difference and give someone the gift of life and be a part of the 32% by registering to become an organ donor at this link. If you're interested in videos like these, subscribe to our YouTube channel, Demystifying Medicine.